I'm the traditional head for the Wanuo of Maduata, a province that looks out to the Great Reef. I live in the village and I'm living my dream to ensure that my children, my grandchildren enjoy the same enjoyment that I'm doing now. When I was a kid growing up, I used to spend holidays at an island just by the Great Sea Reef. And we used to swim, spearfishing or just going line fishing with my friends. And back then there wasn't very, very much activity, you know. Lifestyle was at a slow pace, you know. People weren't so adamant about cash, you know. People would just go plant their own food and fish just enough for them for each day. Money wasn't the big thing then. The big thing then was the how life continued each day. Growing up, I used to see the elders, how they protected, how they sustained the environment. There was no litter. You know? They, when they got the fish, they just got what was enough for them for each day, and maybe a few more just to sell off just for their sugar and salt, for the basics. But there was no overfishing. That's what is being done today. There was no night fishing, night diving then. There wasn't. So that is the memory that I have. And compared to that's the last 40, 50 years. For Fiji, we need to have to strengthen our community ties. The community has to have our one vision. They have to have one mission, one goal, to ensure that there is enough for their future, for the future generation. That is the first thing. Once they have that, they have adopted it, then they can work into doing things that will help them sustain that for the future. I have told my fellow chiefs to that we are going to change the way how we do our, we give our consent for the utilization of our resources. We are going to change the way we go our, do about our fishing. And the impact has been, you know, it has been acknowledged by some of the community, some of the stakeholders. And they've seen the tremendous increase in the activities of the communities. Every Fijian in Fiji, brought up by the ocean, the first thing they see as they grow up, they will ask questions, and they will always see there's always a reef that has prompted them to see what's the importance of the reef. And for me, in my traditional area, in my Ngolinguli, the Great Sea Reef, it's not only a life, it's a source of sanctuary for us and for the fish and for the marine life. That is why it's important to me. The first challenge, I would say, is the environmental impact on the reefs, on the shores and the ecosystem. High rising sea level that has damages the shores, the different species of fish that has been caught, and the declining marine environmental things, you know, dead corals, dead reefs. People now go far to fish. So those are the challenges that we have. In the community level, the conservation, the awareness, it's there. They're taking that three steps forward. But there are only elements in our society that are always be the ones that are always diverting or diverting our struggle to ensure sustainability, you know, because of the players in the industry, I would suppose. They're paying more money for that. I'm the traditional leader of a province, and it's like I am being bestowed the responsibility of not only the livelihood of the community. I'm bestowed the responsibility and the upkeep of all the resources, the flora and the fauna of the reef and the ridge, everything that falls within my province. It's my responsibility to ensure that it is protected and enjoyed. My job is just to continue, to have that continuity of what my forefathers have done, so that the community sees and, you know, they will follow. That is something that I feel that is I'm quite responsible for. I will take my vision. When I look at those in 10 years from now, I don't have to go far in fishing. I don't have to fish to exceed what I have. I'll just fish for my daily living. I think I'll bring back those old glory days. We'll have enough food. We will have enough fish to eat. We'll still have a forest, pristine forest, and we will have more cleaner waters now running through those streams. And we'll have controlled development where the community have the power to control the development. For me, 10 years from now, I can see that. I'll be sitting down in my beach in Maduata in Anduri, and I'll be sitting on a hammock, maybe on a coconut tree, and looking at the great sheriff. And I'll go back and I'll thank all the partners that were part of my journey. WWF one, they had been the backbone of my success, of my struggle, of my fight for recognition of this great sheriff. WCS, other NGOs, non-governmental organization, not forgetting the government, our current prime minister, who has been very supportive. I remember the day he had to reschedule his program to come to one of the small islands just off my coast to come and launch the International Year of the Reef. That is why I take my hat out and I bow to my prime minister, and I support him in any way, in what way, to ensure that the goals and the dreams of the COP25 is achieved. I would say there are two ways to go about it. One is just follow what we are doing in Fiji, get recognition, get the community involved, work with my recommended partner, WWF. So the advice is that utilize what is there around them, and then, you know, see what we are enjoying here in Fiji, and try to live like a Fijian.